everyone. And welcome to part two of this extremely relaxing treatment I'm doing for my wonderful friend Laura tonight. So in part one we did a gua sha style facial massage for Laura, and we introduced some aromatherapy within that and some light touch as well. So in part two I'm going to be doing a very gentle yet quite invigorating scalp treatment for Laura. So we hope you enjoy. So I'm going to begin the treatment with using this terahertz comb. Using backwards and forwards movements over the scalp and through her hair. And what this is going to do is it's really going to help stimulate the scalp. It will help to improve blood circulation in this area as well, and that can really help to stimulate the hair follicles as well. So any kind of massage or combing like this is going to be really beneficial for scalp health. It's also going to help with any strain or tension you may be holding, as a nice amount of pressure applied to the scalp is just really going to help alleviate that tense feeling that you may be holding on to. I'm also going to make sure to massage the back of the scalp and the top of the neck, because this is also a very important area. It holds most of the strain from the day. So it's equally as important to pay a little bit of attention to the nape area of the neck. Just the amount of tension that can be relieved from this area just by a simple massage is amazing. Including massaging down the neck a little bit also. So I'm now going to move on to the scalp scaling part of the treatment, and I have here my little brush. I also have some lovely rosemary oil I'm wanting to use, and my jojoba oil as well. And what I will do is I will take a decent amount of the jojoba oil. Literally just one drop of the rosemary oil is required. And I love to use jojoba oil because it's such a light oil, it's perfect for the scalp. I also have my very soft bristle brush here with me. And it should be nice and soft on the scalp. I'm not wanting to apply too much friction to the scalp tonight. And I'm then taking my brush and very gently running it all the way down the scalp from the hairline to the crown. And then lightly painting on this wonderful rosemary oil. And I will repeat that all over the scalp, leaving about just under an inch between my separations in the hair, because I am pointing the brush in all directions whilst I'm travelling down the scalp. So all areas of the scalp are being brushed. I feel okay. And the wonderful thing about a treatment like this is it does not have to be perfect. You can kind of create it into whatever you wish or what is needed at that time. You can add oils or mousses or creams. For tonight, I'm keeping it simple with a delicate rosemary oil because it's more for relaxation. Continue on to the other side of the scalp. Again, just working my way from the hairline down to the crown. This treatment is going to do is it's really going to help lift any dead skin cells away from the surface of the scalp or any dry skin in general. And then the oil will really help to soften and nourish the scalp as well. And rosemary oil is well known for its properties in aiding in scalp health, so I wanted to include that also. The great thing about rosemary oil is it has a slight tingling effect, which feels really pleasant on the scalp, so it's a nice oil to use. Making sure to give all areas a good brush, and then using the remainder of the oil into the back of the scalp as well. And again, I'll quickly repeat that on the other side. And I can honestly tell you that this feels even better than how it looks. It feels so amazing to have this kind of treatment done. And again, just quickly following that brush over the front hairline, giving it a really good scratch. Okay, so now we've applied the oil, I'm wanting to really rub that in to the scalp now, so I'm going to be quite vigorous with my movements, almost as if I were washing the hair, so trying to create a little bit of friction and just allowing that oil to reach the roots of the hair and also the midlumps as well. Making sure to give some attention to the back of the scalp again. Just following that movement all around the scalp. And I'll then take a moment just to play with the hair a little bit. And again, this will enable the oils to travel down the hair a little bit as well. I'm now going to use a different kind of comb. This is a jade stone comb. And again, I'm going to take a few moments to run this over Laura's scalp and also through the lengths of her hair as well. And again, we're just allowing that oil to find its way from the scalp into the hair. We're really making this oil work for us tonight. And with all of the massaging of the oil into the scalp and also the heat from Laura's scalp, we are really getting that lovely aroma of rosemary. So I'm hoping that that is also aiding in Laura's relaxation. I also like to incorporate a little bit of hair tugging and twisting. So I'll take all of the hair and gently twist it. And I then also like to separate the hair into two pieces and then take them and twist them around one another. And also give the scalp a little tug. This movement alone can give you so much relief from tension on the scalp, and if you do it in even smaller sections, it can feel really, really wonderful. Now I'm going to take my massage oil, and this one is beautiful. And I'm going to do a very relaxing neck and shoulder massage for Laura tonight. I'll then begin to run that beautiful oil over her décolleté area, the tops of her arms, her shoulders, and her neck. And I'm going to use my fingertips and my knuckles in the areas which I feel she may need a little bit more attention. And that is usually the tops of the shoulders and the lower part of the neck. And Laura did in fact tell me earlier that she has been suffering with neck pain in the mornings. So I have advised her to try a different pillow, because sometimes it can be something as simple as that. And I said that I would also pay a little bit of attention to the muscles around this area for her as well. So I'm going to take a few minutes to try and work out some of that knotting in this area, and the built-up tension and strain that we all get from time to time. Gently stroking over the collarbone area as well. This is an extremely sensitive and delicate area, and it can feel really pleasant to just run your fingertips over that area for a few moments. I'm turning Laura to the side because I'm really wanting to focus on this area which has been troubling her the past few weeks. So I'm going to take a few moments to just knead this area and try and soften that tension down that she's holding in the muscles around the neck. I do love to use aromatherapy in a lot of my treatments. I think it can be ever so beneficial because it can help relax a person's so much, and if they are reminded of being relaxed whilst inhaling that wonderful aroma, it can almost be used as therapy for when people are feeling anxious or stressed. This is why I do enjoy creating toners or sprays or oils for my clients, so that they can take them home, because if they do begin to start feeling stressed again, they can just use their personalised aroma, which was used throughout their treatment, and it almost brings them back to feeling that relaxation from their treatment. So it can be extremely beneficial in a very therapeutic way. That same massage on the other side of her neck, the back of the neck. Just trying to incorporate the bottom of the scalp into it as well. So I'm just supporting Laura's head with my hand, just to gain access to the top of the neck area, the lower scalp area, for a moment. And to finish the treatment, I'm going to use this really nice eye massager, and it's been in my little fridge, so it's nice and cold. And I'm going to run that over both the bottom and the tops of Laura's eyes. And because we've done quite a lot of massaging tonight, she will possibly wake up a little bit puffy tomorrow, so this is just going to help alleviate any of that puffiness she may have found to have around the eye area. I will finish with her aromatherapy spray, which she will take home. and her treatment for tonight is complete. Thank you so much for joining us tonight, and a really big thank you to Laura for coming and filming with me tonight, even though she's not feeling her best. But I truly hope she's feeling a lot better after this treatment tonight, and I really hope she has a good night's sleep. And I hope you have a good night's sleep as well. If you like this video, please do give it a thumbs up. But until next time, take care, and I'll see you soon. Bye.